Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 907, and today's topic is the manufacture of varnishes. Varnishes are different from paints because varnishes does not contain color pigments. That is the main difference of varnishes and paints. And varnishes are colloidal solution or thick solution of resins, and these resins may be synthetic or natural, which are dispersed in solvent. It may be volatile solvent like spirit. And these varnishes, they are mainly used for coating purposes, surface coating, and as well as for decoration purpose. And since it doesn't contain any colored pigment, so it is not having any fluorescent or shining reflection of light by absorption. It is just is having similar color. And there are mainly two type of varnishes. One is that is called spirit varnishes. Spirit varnishes, here the resins are dispersed in methylated spirit, and this spirit varnish will not be containing thinner, and it can crack easily on the surface. And these varnishes, their drying chemistry is similar like paint, but it is very fast as compared to paint. First is that evaporation, and second the oxidation of resins, and third polymerization of the double bonds. So these three chemical procedures or reactions are involved in drying of the varnishes. The second varnish is called oleaginous varnishes. Here the synthetic or natural resins are dispersed in oil, and these resins, synthetic ones, may be urea formaldehyde, phenol formaldehyde, rosin formaldehyde. These are all the synthetic resins which are used. And here these varnishes are good in sense that it is durable, and it doesn't contain any color pigment. And also the varnishes are classified on the basis of dilution, and that dilution means if we are taking 1 pound of synthetic or a natural resin, that's rubber like material, and if it is dispersed or dissolved in 5 to 15 gallon of oil as a solvent, then it is called salt varnishes. And here the plasticizer is added, because if plasticizer is not added, then easily it can be cracked. So it works as anti-cracking agent. The second one is where 1 pound of resin is dispersed or added in 15 to 35 gallons of oil, and that is called medium varnishes. And the third one is where the quantity of oil is 35 to 50 a gallon, and it is called long varnishes. And if in case pigments are added in the varnishes, then that is called enamel. So enamel chemistry I will be discussing later on. Here I am mainly discussing the varnishes and what are their chemical constituents, what is the raw material and how we are going to manufacture. So here I am discussing the manufacture of varnishes. So first we will be discussing the chemical constituents like the solvent, oil, resins, synthetic and natural resins. So number one, let me define the varnishes means they are different from paint because pigment is not added, it is unpigmented colloidal solution. Number one, varnish may be regarded as an unpigmented colloidal dispersion or solution of natural or synthetic or both resins in oils. That is the definition of the varnishes. They are used as protective or decorating coating for various surfaces. They dry on the surface by evaporation, oxidation and polymerization of its constituents, and all this oxidation, polymerization and evaporation I have already discussed in previous lectures. Number two, varnishes are of two types. Roman one, that is called spirit varnishes. These are colloidal solution of natural resins such as cera, rosin, copal, damar and kauri gum. These are natural resins and they are forming colloidal solution in the oil. These resins are dispersed in methylated spirit or other completely volatile non-film forming solvent. So this is actually these resins are dispersed in methylated spirit. Methylated spirit means actually methyl alcohol is added little bit so that people should not use for their personal purpose. That type of spirit is called methylated spirit. It is toxic for use. And these varnishes dry more rapidly but undergo cracking and peeling in the presence of plasticizers. Roman 2, that is oleoresinous varnishes. These are the solutions of one or more natural or synthetic resins in the drying oil and volatile solvent. Some plasticizers may also be added to the oil in order to check the cracking of the varnish. Urea formaldehyde resin, phenol formaldehyde resin, vinyl resin, melamine formaldehyde resin are the main synthetic resin that have been used for making these varnishes. Oils used here are linseed oil, tongue oil, castor oil, soybean oil and tall oil. So I have given the synthetic resins which are used, all the formaldehyde resin, that is phenol formaldehyde, urea formaldehyde, melamine formaldehyde, and the oils which are used, linseed oil, soybean oil, castor oil. So these are all the chemical constituents of oleoresinous resins. Turpentine oil is used as a solvent. Varnishes have also been classified into three classes. So as I have already told you, that further varnishes are classified into three classes depending upon the quantity of resin in oil, and that resin may be 100 pound. So in 5 to 15 gallon, if 1 pound of resin is dispersed, it is called salt. Varnishes like that, middle and long. So it is given here. Number 3, varnishes have also been classified into 3 classes according to the number of gallons of oil used per 100 pound of resins. A, salt type varnishes. These varnishes made with 6 to 15 gallons of oil per 100 pound of resin. They are known as salt type varnishes and they possess fast drying properties. B, that is middle type varnishes. These varnishes are made with 20 to 30 gallons of oil per 100 pounds of resin. C, long type varnishes. These varnishes are made up with 35 to 60 gallons of oil per 100 pounds of resin. These long type varnishes forms more weather resistant film. Note, since varnishes do not contain any pigment, I have already told you in the beginning that these varnishes, once we call varnish, means it is unpigmented, it is without pigment. So since varnishes do not contain any pigment, they are less resistant to light than paints. So this is the good quality of paint, that they are very much resistant to light, because these pigments are responsible of reflecting or absorbing different short or longer wavelength of light. But since in varnishes there is no any pigment, so it is not light resistant. Thus varnishes differ from paints in that they have no pigments, and in varnishes a part or whole of the oil is substituted by only resin. Drying oil of oil results in the formation of a highly polymerized product which is quite similar to resin. So because of that similarity of the resin, what now in varnishes manufacturing units, so in varnish oil is replaced by resin. So with this I will stop, and in the next lecture I am going to discuss this. I have discussed about the chemical constituents, and in the next lecture, that is second part of varnishes, is raw material and manufacturing. Once again, thank you very much for watching the lecture.